Hello, and today we'll be checking out the updated plugin for the Magento 2 platform-based marketplace web store. That's the Magento 2 multi-vendor marketplace RMX shipping plugin. So now the marketplace admin as well as the marketplace vendors would be able to provide their customers with the RMX shipping method so that they can get their orders delivered at their doorsteps. Now the admin needs to have his own account options or the account at the RMX, and the same goes for the marketplace vendors as well. And thereafter, whenever a customer proceeds further, adds a product to the cart and tries to make a checkout, he'll be able to see the Webcool's RMX shipping. Now this title can also be changed from the admin backend panel under the respective plugins configuration. And before we proceed further, and let me show you how the customers can make use of the same and can place the order using the RMX shipping. Thereafter, we'll be showing you how the vendors can set up their origin address along with the setup for the RMX shipping under their own account panel. And lastly, we'll take you through the admin's end, having the same functionalities there as well. So before we proceed further, please do subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to receive the latest updates. Apart from that, if you find this particular video helpful, then do kindly give it a thumbs up. So here you can see that I've added one product, that's the formal bag in the cart, and I've tapped on the view and edit cart. Now here I've chosen my country, state and province, and according to the zip code, etc., we can see that we are able to see the RMX shipping method. And these are the method, this is the shipping, and these are the different carrier methods that can be chosen by the customers. So let's choose PDX. The same is visible here. Shipping is Webcool RMX and the method name is PDX. So let's tap here and then proceed to checkout, and let's place the order. Now the same RMX shipping methods would be visible to the customers at the checkout time as well. So if I scroll down, here you can see that we have the shipping methods, and here's our RMX shipping, both of the pricing for the different carriers that are there for choosing by the customers. So we'll go for the $648.45, and we'll just tap here on the next button, and on the payment page we'll be choosing the payment method that we're going to use. So I'll just choose it as chicken money for the time being. And now we'll be tapping here to place the order. So here as well, you can see that under the order history, we have the shipping name or the title along with the method name and the total price for the shipment itself. And you can see that the order has been placed. Now let's check the order number 575. So we'll be able to see the chosen shipping method carrier there by the customer. That's basically for the customer to see or to verify the chosen shipping carrier. So here's our product for $10, and here's the shipping being added here. And here's the shipping method, that's the Webcool RMX shipping using the PDX method. Now after the invoice has been generated by the marketplace vendor, we'll have a section here within the vendor can enter the tracking ID and can generate the shipments at a later time as well. So that's how the customers can place the orders using the RMX shipping at the checkout or within the view and edit cart section there, and can check the chosen shipping method. Now coming to the vendors, and the marketplace vendors will have to set up their origin address, and for that you can see that we have the RMX configuration for the plugin itself, and we have the shipping settings. So let me open the shipping settings and the RMX configuration for the vendor end. Now the main initial configurations for this RMX shipping are within the admin backend panel, so we'll be seeing that at a later time. Right now the vendors can first set the origin address, and then they can basically manage the RMX configuration by entering their account details so that they're connected to the same. Now under the origin, you'll have to set up your shipping origin address, because this is used by the RMX to calculate the shipping cost. So here you'll be setting up your shipping origin address, your phone number, street address, city, state, zip code and the country. Thereafter, just tap here on the save button. Now coming to the other section, that's the manage AtomX configuration. Under the AtomX configuration, here you'll have to enter your AtomX account number that you have received after successful registration at the AtomX, and after going through the different steps or the levels there. Then you have the AtomX email. This is the email that you used for the registration, and then we have the AtomX password. This is basically the account email that is used for login, and this is the password provided by the AtomX itself. Here's the AtomX pin, the AtomX entity, and the AtomX country code. So these details are to be filled, and then tap here in the save button. Now at the storefront, whenever a customer purchases or adds this vendor's product into the cart to make a checkout, they'll be able to see the marketplace AtomX shipping method that will be displaying different available carriers, and from those the customer can choose anyone as a shipping carrier for their orders. Now this was the vendor's configuration. I showed you the customer flow as well. Now coming to the order history, we had placed the order for the 575 order number, and this is right now the marketplace vendor's dashboard on the left hand side. So here's the order number. Okay, that particular order that we placed was off the marketplace admin. So the same goes for here as well. You can basically process the order. Let me show you that on the admin's end. So just give me a second. So let me log into the admin backend panel. So the particular order that we paid for the formal bank was of the admin. So that's why the order number 575 is not visible here for this respective vendor. So let me cross it out. So first I'll show you the order. So I'll just go to sales and orders, and thereafter we'll be checking the initial configuration settings for the plugin itself. Now here under the orders, if I scroll down, here's the order number 575. Its status is pending. Let's tap on the view link under the actions column, and that would bring up the complete details of the order itself. So here you can see that formal bag, price was 10, and the shipping and handling charges are $648.45. And under the shipping and handling info as well, you can see we could have mixed shipping. The method used is PDX for $648.45. Now from here, the admin can generate the invoice for the order that has been placed. So let me generate the invoice. So within the invoice as well, we have the respective details for the shipping and handling, the SAP here, and the submitted invoice. At the same time, we can also email a copy of the invoice to the customer by checking this email copy of invoice checkbox and then tapping on the submit invoice button. You can see that on the invoice page as well, we have the title for the method name and the carrier as well. So we have generated the invoice, and now let me tap here in the ship button. Let's create a shipment for this. So here the shipping address, the shipping information you can see. Now after you have basically set up for the shipping there, what you need to do is you'll get a tracking number from the AtomX itself. So you'll have to add that tracking number here. So it can be a custom value, or you can choose from the carriers as well. So here we have the vehicle AtomX shipping, the title, and let me enter the tracking number, and thereafter I'll just scroll down to the end, tap here on the submit shipped in. So you can see that the shipping has been created. Now if I scroll down, okay, alright, here's the total paid $658.45. Now if I go to the shipments, and here's the shipment that we've created. Let's tap on the view button, and that's it. That's how we can send the tracking number to the customers as well. After you've sent the parcel out to the AtomX for pickup, you'll get the tracking number from them. To create a shipping label, just tap here on the create shipping label. Then you'll have to choose your package for the same. So I'll just go for 10. So actually, you need to first generate the package before you're going to ship the product. And then you'll have to add the products to the package. This is the formal bag. I'll choose that up. Add selected products to package. You can see now it's not editable. And then we'll just tap here in the. Now let's hop onto the backend configuration and let's see how it can be done. So we'll go to the stores and then configuration. On the configuration page, we'll have to navigate to the sales section. So let me scroll down and sales. So first of all, the marketplace admin needs to set his shipping settings, wherein he'll be setting up his origin itself. And then we have the shipping methods. Let's open that in another window. So here you can see that the admin needs to enter the origin itself. And kindly note that the cash on delivery for the Aramex is available within the domestic system itself and not internationally. So here's the origin. You have set up the origin. Tap on the save button. So this origin, we just chose it from the configuration section under the sales. Now this is the configuration for the marketplace shipping methods, and here we have the Whipcool marketplace Aramex shipping. So we'll choose it as a yes to enable this functionality to have the Aramex shipping courier types available for the customers to choose so that they can get the products delivered at their home step. Then we have the option to set up this plugin in a testing or a sandbox mode or a live or a live instance. So for the sandbox, you'll choose yes. Otherwise, to make use in the production one, you'll choose it as a no. You'll set up the title. The same title is visible to the customers at the checkout time. You'll enter your account email, account PIN, password, account number, account entity, the account country code. So these details would be available with you when you register with the Aramex itself, and according to their procedures, when that is up, you'll get these details. Then you can choose the weight units as pound or kilograms. You can also allowed domestic methods can be chosen. So these are the Aramex options or the carrier methods basically. And from here, you can choose the allowed domestic methods available for the customers to choose. And you can, if you remember, this was the international methods, the Priority Parcel Express and the Priority Document Express, PDX and PPE. So from here, you can choose the international methods available to the customers, and these are for the domestic ones. You can choose to enable the COD, otherwise you can disable it by choosing a no as well. Then you can set up the COD instructions for the customers to read. You can choose the cash and delivery charge as well. If you want to ship to specific countries, you can do that as well. For now, we have set it as all allowed. You can choose specific, then choose the countries or multi-select the countries that you want to use it for. So right now, we'll set it as all allowed countries. This particular error message would be visible to the customers if the shipping address is not shippable. So this particular or the shipping method is not available. So this display error message would be visible under the section of the shipping there. You can choose to add the handling fee as well. Apart from that, you'll be choosing the volumetric weight enabled as yes or no. Whether you want to allow the sellers to save the Aramex details. Now, if this is set as no, then the vendors would not be able to enter their Aramex account details as we just saw within the vendors end. And for here, you'll choose it as yes, then they can add their own Aramex details under their own account panel. So you can choose to show the method if it's not applicable. If you have chosen it as yes, then this particular message gets displayed. And lastly, you can choose the debug mode as yes or no. So that was the backend configuration. After that, you will just tap here in the save configuration, and we are done configuring the Magento 2 Multi-Vendor Marketplace Aramex Shipping plugin. And one more thing for the volumetric weight enable, if this option is enabled by the admin, then the shipping will be calculated on the basis of the volumetric weight. And if the products that are to be shipped are more in number, then the shipping rate shall be less, as the rate is tabulated on the basis of the volume of the shipment itself. So this is a demo shipping label generation. As you can see right now, and for this is for the admin's end, and this one is for the marketplace vendor end. Now I just forgot to tell you, while we have created the invoice, we are going to generate the new shipment. We have the tracking number. So before adding the tracking number, kindly do check this option here, create shipping label, and then you can add your basically the tracking number. Then tap here in the sub. So if I tap here in the submit shipment, we'll have that particular pop-up so as to set the. And now you can see that under the shipping and handling, we have the track order link, and this is the respective shipping method. Now if I go to the customer order section here and I refresh the page, so here as well we should have that particular tracking link available to the customers. So you can see that the order for the shipment is done there. And now if we go to the order shipment section, here you can see that the items ordered and the order shipment, the shipping method, and here's the option to track this shipment for the customers there. So that was much about the Magento2 Multi-Vendor Marketplace RMX shipping plugin, and I hope it helped you out in understanding the flow of the same. If you still have any questions, queries, suggestions or requirements, then kindly do get back to us at support@webcool.com, raise a ticket at webcool.uvdesk.com, or you can also contact us through www.webcool.com/contacts. Lastly, if you find this particular video helpful, then do kindly give it a thumbs up, and thanks for watching this particular video, and have a great day ahead.